Our next speaker is a consummate chef, an author, a restaurateur, and an entrepreneur. He holds a place in Limca Book of World Records for longest road journey by a chef, having traveled 20,000 kilometers of India by road to explore Indian cuisine. He was invited as a guest judge in MasterChef Australia. So guys, this guy is not branding butter chicken, but then he's a brand himself. So guys, presenting to you
our next speaker for Paradise Group presents Next the Conclave 2019, co-sponsored by HPCL, Mr. Saransh Goila. Please welcome him with a huge round of applause.
भूख लग रही है इसलिए मैं यहाँ हूँ. सो व्हाट अ अमेजिंग प्लेटफॉर्म राइट. सबको भूख लग रही हो तो शेफ को खड़ा कर दो. ऑफ कोर्स. सो हम कुछ बना के खिलाएंगे. फिलहाल तो मैं बातें खिलाऊंगा, खाना बाद में खिलाऊंगा. सो लेट्स डू दिस. सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट माय टॉक, हाउ अबाउट वी शो इंडिया
कि मुंबई में जोश कितना है. कड़क कड़क काफी, चाय की तरह कड़क है. अमेजिंग अमेजिंग. तो एक काम करते हैं, आई एम गोइंग टू से सड़क और आप लोग बोलोगे शेफ. ठीक है, चालू करते हैं. 3, 2, 1 सड़क सड़क सड़क. अमेजिंग अमेजिंग. व्हाट अ रूम फुल ऑफ अमेजिंग यूथ एंड काफी इलेक्ट्रिक प्लेटफॉर्म है. तो एक इलेक्ट्रिक कोट से शुरू करते हैं. लोग क्या कहेंगे हैज किल्ड मेनी ड्रीम्स, बट लोग क्या खाएंगे हैज मेड मैनी ड्रीम्स कम ट्रू. मेरा कुछ जो जर्नी है वो इसी कोट से शुरू होता है, बिकॉज आई कम फ्रॉम अ वेरी स्मॉल पार्ट ऑफ दिल्ली विच इज कॉल्ड पीतमपुरा. इट्स लाइक अ लिटिल टाइनी पार्ट ऑफ दिल्ली जहाँ पे कोई किसी को नहीं पूछता, क्योंकि दिल्ली की अगर आप पूछें लोगों से आप कहाँ से हैं, हर किसी का जवाब क्या होगा, मैं साउथ दिल्ली से हूँ. बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली मैं नॉर्थ दिल्ली से हूँ. एंड यू नो व्हेन आई वाज ग्रोइंग अप,
इमेजिन अ क्लासिक लिविंग रूम कि आपका घर में ड्राइंग रूम है, ऊपर से स्पॉटलाइट लगी हुई है चार, यहाँ पे योर डैड इज सिटिंग, हियर योर मॉम इज सिटिंग, हियर योर ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स और योर अंकल और समबडी इन द फैमिली इज सिटिंग, एंड दे आर आस्किंग यू एंड दे आर डिसाइडिंग कि व्हाट डू यू वांट टू डू इन योर लाइफ. सो माय मॉम हैड अ वर्जन ऑफ मी कि मेरा बेटा बायोटेक इंजीनियर बनेगा, एंड माय डैड हैड अ वर्जन ऑफ मी दैट my son is going to do economics. My grandparents had another version of me ki hamara beta ye karega.
So when I was 17 years old, when they were all discussing ki main life mein kya karna chahta hu, I somehow managed to speak aur maine bola ki mujhe chef nahi banna hai, mujhe actor banna hai. And the reactions that I got from that living room were like, my mom was like, huh, देखा है अपने आप को. एंड दैट टाइम आई यूज टू बी लाइक रियली प्लम्प. आई यूज टू बी अराउंड 90 kgs एंड आई वॉज शॉर्ट इन हाइट, साइड पार्टिंग. अगर तुम्हारे ज़माने में ये नहीं था, पर जस्सी जैसी कोई नहीं एक सीरियल था, और ओके वाओ एवरीबडी नोज अबाउट इट, सो फैंटास्टिक. सो आई एम नॉट दैट ओल्ड. सो आई यूज टू बी दैट जस्सी इन माई फैमिली. इमेजिन अ जस्सी गेटिंग अप एंड सेइंग मुझे एक्टर बनना है. And then my dad is like, beta, theater, paise. And I'm like, dad, okay. So that was a strict cross. And everybody kind of shut my dreams down just because I said ki mujhe actor banna hai. You are a boy in Pitampura who's dreaming of becoming an actor. Nobody cares about it. So wahan pe wo discussion khatam ho gaya. And then when the time really came after 12th standard ki life mein karna kya hai, I was one of those boys who was good at studying. I was excellent in my board exams, and but I never wanted to pursue biotechnology or economics. Mere ko kuch andar ka artist jo hai usko explore karna tha. And when my friends and classmates were playing cricket outside in the field, main kitchen mein khada hoke rotiya bana raha tha. So I know, I'm sorry, I'm talking about food now. We're getting to that part of the conversation. But imagine a stack of aloo parathas with... with a bit of butter melting away. So that is the first dish that I made in my life. When I was 13 years old, tab mujhe pata nahi tha ki meko chef banna hai. But I was a cook by hobby. And it was midnight, aur mere ghar pe kisi ki shaadi hone wali thi, and everybody was really hungry. So out of nowhere, this little boy gets up and says, main banaunga. And everybody started laughing at me. They're like, isko bhook lag rahi hai, so he's delusional. Ye bol raha hai, kitchen ja ke aloo parathe banayega. So there were some boiled potatoes in the fridge. Masale mujhe andaaza tha ki kitne dalne hain. My chacha, who was getting married, he came with me in the kitchen and we made 22 parathas that night. And I was 13 years old back then and everybody was really confused. They thought I am a person who just likes to eat because of my size and not somebody who can actually cook. In fact, I was so popular as a kid in my family, as a kid who eats. Agar us time pe hashtag hote, my hashtag would be how to eat at weddings. क्योंकि जितनी भी शादियों पे मैं जाता था, they would look for my verdict. I will tell them, इस शादी में पाव भाजी अच्छी है, इस शादी में गोलगप्पे अच्छे हैं. I was also popular, in fact, at one wedding, just to challenge people around me, I had 24 milkshakes. Pretty, मैं लगता नहीं हूँ ऐसा, but मैं कर सकता हूँ. So, that's how my journey started, my food journey started. And my food journey has been very interesting. It was my hobby, which became into my profession, and then it became my passion. So you see, the translation of, there are three translations that happened in my life. Ki banna to tha actor, ban gaya chef. So when the 12th exams got over, I gave all the entrance exams. Maine biotechnology ka diya, BBA karne ke liye exam diya, aur hotel management ka diya, kyunki papa ne bola ki in dono jagah nahi hoga, तो तू होटल मैनेजमेंट कर लियो. इफ नथिंग वर्क्स आउट फॉर यू, यू डू होटल मैनेजमेंट. एंड दैट इज एग्जैक्टली व्हाट हैपेंड. आई क्लियर्ड नॉट अ सिंगल एंट्रेंस एग्जाम. आई वाज अ साइंस स्टूडेंट विद एक्सीलेंट मार्क्स इन माय बोर्ड एग्जाम्स, बट आई डिडंट क्लियर अ सिंगल बोर्ड एग्जाम. व्हाई इज दैट? बिकॉज आई डिडंट, हां, बिकॉज थर्ड ऑप्शन, वेरी वेरी स्मार्ट, एनीबडी हु हैड पॉइंटेड इट आउट. Because I really didn't want to go in that field and it was not in my heart. And hotel management sort of chose me instead of me choosing it as a career, where every entrance exam that I went to, I cleared it like this. And it kind of became a natural fit for me. Ki, is there a hand in a glove sort of a situation? So that's how this journey for me kind of took a flip and I started to work towards something that I really loved. My grandfather used to say, a friend in need is a friend indeed, but a friend who can feed is the friend you need. And I took that lesson from him, and it's a small sad story, but before I went to college, I spent 2 hours with my grandfather because my college was in Aurangabad and I was going to leave home to go to a hostel. And he gave me a very important life advice where he was sitting in his room. He is 76 years old and I didn't know back then that when I was going to go to college, he passed away after I joined my college in 3 months. So I never got a chance to meet him again. But before leaving, he told me that today I am 76 years old, I have lived my life to its best. But if I have to look back and I have to think of that one thing that I, you know, regret, or that one thing that I couldn't fulfill, is the fact that I could not understand what was my purpose in this life. Now imagine that I was 18 years old, so meko to aise dimag ke upar se nikal gaya. But what he said makes a lot of sense to me right now. I think it's very important for all of us to ask this question when you grow up, when you are growing up, what is your purpose in life? What is your dream? What is it that really makes you happy? Does acting make you happy? Does cooking make you happy? Does being a doctor make you happy? Does being an engineer make you happy? Khushi kis cheez se milti hai? You have to ask yourselves that. And I kind of took this quote away from him, and I continued and pursued my journey as a chef in a hotel management school. And yeah, that is how my life sort of changed. But after that, when I graduated, I became a chef. I went to a hotel. My first job was at the Leela's in Bangalore, jahan pe main aisa full on chef fights. Imagine, you know, how you imagine a chef. By now, my family has changed from beta tu bavarchi banega to my son has become a chef. You know, we had seen this translation in India from chefs being cooks or bavarchis to chefs being chefs. MasterChef India started. MasterChef Australia became immensely popular in this country. And when I was working in that hotel as a chef, I used to ask myself that what is it that I really want to do? I realized that Indian khane ke bare mein bahut sare log baat nahin karte hain. I wanted to be an advocate of Indian food, and that's how my next journey started, where I actually, when I was doing well in my career as a chef, I quit my job. I came to Mumbai and I enrolled myself into an acting course. Yes, yes. So this is a 23-year-old boy who is well-established, who loves what he is doing. I love cooking and it's my hobby. But wo kida hota hai na ek dimag mein ki mere paas ek aisa skill hai jo explore nahi hua hai, mujhe lagta hai main usme bahut acha hu. So let me go and explore it. And by now my parents are like, ye to gaya. 4 years education, 2 years of being a chef, he has quit all of that. And he's moved to Mumbai. And by now, my parents don't have a say in this because I have saved some money to do this acting course and manage my funds in Mumbai. So they never fought with me, but they said, "Theek hai, abhi hum kuch nahi kar sakte. Now, if you want to quit your job, if you want to go, you go." So I did a 6-month acting course here in Mumbai at Barry John's acting studio. And you know what that acting course did to me? It helped me find my purpose. Because after that acting course, I realized that I still want to be a chef. And I don't want to be an actor. But I had this amazing opportunity to at least find my journey. To be able to tell myself, ha, tomorrow when I'm 70 and old, I don't want to be a person who says, ki meko mauka nahi mila. Because how do you create opportunities? You create them. They don't walk up to you. So when your parents are saying no, when you yourself are telling yourself that you don't deserve to be an actor because of the way you look or because of the way you cook, it does not matter. You have to push through that barrier and go ahead and give it a shot. If it does not work out, so be it. And yeah, post that, I go back to being a chef. I realized that there weren't many people in the industry who had the skill that I had. That's that unique skill of somebody who can speak, somebody who can teach people about Indian food, somebody who can talk about ki hamare desh ke har kone mein 200 kilometer mein taste of water, taste of food, spices, the way you cook it, the way we serve it, everything changes. And that's how I started in this direction of ki mujhe chef Sanjeev Kapoor ki tarah banna hai. And that was one of my long-lasting dreams, where I always found it fascinating that that man is so charming and he taught the entire country to cook. Everybody knows about him? Of course, guru and legend. So I started taking baby steps towards trying to figure out how do I educate people about Indian food. That won't happen with me being in a standard job, where I can be in a restaurant and I can be a chef and I can cook every night the same dish, but how do I make sure that my voice reaches out to 1 million people, or at least across the globe. So I thought the easiest route is, let me look for him. And you know what I started doing? I started contacting my professors, I started writing emails, I started shooting arrows in the dark, where jahan pe bhi mauka milega, try karke dekhte hain. What's the harm in that, right? There is nothing to lose. And 2 years of doing that, I shifted back to Delhi because, of course, my funds were over. I was sitting at home. I was very depressed. My dad runs a manufacturing unit of hand pumps. like the proper Sunny Deval hand pumps. And he, in fact, I started going to my factory for 6 months because I was not being able to fulfill my dream of teaching people about how to cook. And 2 years down the line, after having reached out to hundreds of people, I get a call. And this call comes from an email. This is 2011 June. And this call came from an email that I had sent in 2009 to the CEO of Food Channel, which is a channel that Chef Sanjeev Kapoor runs, saying that we are doing a reality show with Sanjeev Kapoor and Madhuri Dixit. And we are looking for young chefs like you, for you to be on the show. And we would love to audition you. Are you willing to fly down to Mumbai? And I was like, absolutely. I am definitely willing to come back to Mumbai. I just told my dad that Madhuri Dixit ka show hai, main ja raha hun. He was like, haan, haan, ja, beta, ja. And suddenly my dad has gone from me not enrolling in a Barry John's workshop to listening to Madhuri's name and allowing me to go there. But that's how my journey changed. And I would like to believe that it's because of the fact, not because I was lucky, but because of the fact that I was persistent. It took me 3 years, knocking on hundreds of doors, a lot of rejection, where people told me, I don't look the part, I can't do this, I don't fit here. And it sort of all came back to me, right? That email led back to me being on the show. I was the youngest person on Food Maha Challenge. I was also the winner of Food Maha Challenge. And yeah, that's how my life changed. And then the cherry on the top of the cake was, now Food, unlike big channels like Fox or Star Plus, is a Gareeb channel. So when I won, I didn't get a crore rupees in my bank balance. I got one watch and a trip to Italy, which was not bad, and an opportunity to host a food show on Food. And that was my breakthrough in this industry, where I did my first show, which was called Roti Rasta or India, for which I am registered in the Limca Book of Records for being the only chef in the world to have traveled 20,000 kilometers of India by road in 100 days, 60 cities, and we covered our amazing entire country, incredible India, and we made a show out of it. I wrote a book on it called India on My Platter. And that sort of showed me that how amazing India is. So India is truly incredible. And I wholeheartedly believe in that. And that's what my journey has been about. Now I travel across the world. I tell people about Indian food. I tell them about our roots, about our cuisine, about our culture. And I'm very proud when I travel to places like Australia or Sweden or US. And we can talk about our country and culture. One of the amazing things that happened to me in this journey was Goila Butter Chicken. Nice, I like it. I think some people have tried it. And if you haven't tried it, 7400448081. This is delivery number. So please order. Karein. We are available pretty much across Mumbai. And Goila Butter Chicken is almost 3 years old. It's my journey as a chef into becoming an entrepreneur, and I started this I gave birth to this baby of mine 3 years back, and again, we are the only brand from India who made it to MasterChef Australia last year, one of the most iconic reality shows when it comes to food, and amazingly, I was not invited there because I am a chef on TV, but I was invited there because of the recipe of butter chicken that I can make. So I think it was an amazing realization for me that no matter where I go and what I do, what I cook will always be more relevant than the person that I'm going to eventually become or I am. So it's a very proud feeling to have something that's more popular than you as a person. Because when you're popular as a person, you know, fame can get to you. And you start thinking that, array, I know it all. But only when you give birth to something that's more popular than you, and is probably going to live longer than you do, you realize that you've created an impact. You've created something that's, you know, that's relevant, that's going to stick longer than you will in this universe. So I think that's the purest form of joy any creator can get. And I think this is the part of life I am in currently. I'm enjoying my passion for Goila Butter Chicken. We are about 5 outlets in Mumbai now. And I am somebody who started my journey from Pitampura, but I have somehow ended up in Melbourne. So yeah, that's about it. So the floor is open for questions. If you have any questions, happy to take them, happy to answer them. I hope I have been able to encapsulate my journey. And I know sabko bhook lag rahi hai. Pata nahi aloo ke parathe hain lunch mein ya vada pav, I have no idea. Samosa bhi ho sakta hai.
Secret hai wo.
So any cooks in the audience? People who cook? Itne sare log khana banate hain. Main Maggie ki baat nahi kar raha hu. Any non-Maggie cooks in the audience? Not bad at all. I think that's fantastic. That's fantastic. That's so cool. So, anyone here who wants to become a chef? Haan, aise haath saare niche baith gaye. Not bad. I can see about 6-7 people, 8 people who are raising their hands. If you have any questions about the food industry, about restaurants, about entrepreneurship, about how do you follow your dreams, you know what I tell people, the only recipe for success is to really follow your heart. There is no other recipe to success. Agar aapko kuch crack karna hai, you have to hear your heart out and you have to shun everything else that exists. Any questions? Am I taking questions? I can barely see people. I think there's a mic going somewhere, no? You can also shout out your question if I can't see you. No, done?
We have a question.
Haan, there is somebody who's raising their hand there.
Excuse me?
1, 2.
Saransh. So we have
with the mic there.
Oh, sorry, 3.
Okay, yeah. Hello, sir. My question is that as the last point you said that food is related to heart, correct?
Correct.
So then they say that someone's heart is going to the stomach.
Absolutely. My heart's heart is going to my stomach.
So what is your viewpoint about that? And I want to know what is your favorite cuisine?
My favorite cuisine is Indian. I make Indian food, I eat it. Very passionate about Indian food. And not just butter chicken.
Okay.
मैं दिल्ली का लड़का हूँ पर मेरी family fully vegetarian है. So.
Impressive.
Should I tell you? Oh, I forgot. So, my last name is Goila and my venture is called Goila Butter Chicken and my entire family is vegetarian.
Oh.
Imagine the shock they got when I told them I am going to call my venture Goila Butter Chicken. They were like, क्या? हमारा पूरा खानदान वेजिटेरियन है एंड दे लाइक व्हाई कांट यू कॉल इट सरांचेस बटर चिकन एंड देन माय आंसर टू देम वाज यू विल नॉट अंडरस्टैंड इट बट दिस इज द हैशटैग दैट्स ट्रेंडिंग ऑन ट्विटर आई कांट लेट गो ऑफ अ हैशटैग दैट्स ट्रेंडिंग ऑन ट्विटर इट हैज टू बी कॉल्ड गोइला बटर चिकन एंड 6 मंथ्स बैक व्हेन आई केम ऑन मास्टर शेफ ऑस्ट्रेलिया माई अंकल कॉल्ड मी एंड टोल्ड मी बेटा देखो मास्टर शेफ ऑस्ट्रेलिया पे देखा बहुत अच्छा लगा मैंने टोल्ड अंकल कंपनी का नाम है गोइला बटर चिकन आपको अच्छा लगा ही होगा ऑफ कोर्स
ओके थैंक यू सो मच सर
एंड यू आस्क मी समथिंग एल्स एंड ऑफ कोर्स फूड इज अ लॉट ऑफ पैशन अ लॉट ऑफ लव अगर आपको खाने की इंडस्ट्री में रहना है इट्स लॉन्ग वर्किंग आवर्स 10-14 आवर्स इज योर डे मिनिमम मनी इज स्टिल समथिंग दैट्स ग्रोइंग यू नो स्टार्टिंग सैलरीज आर नॉट एज प्रॉमिसिंग एज अदर इंडस्ट्रीज माइट हैव So a reality check for people would be that it's a tough industry, requires a lot of physical labor and salaries are improving but they are not there yet. So you might have to in the first 5 years of your career or journey have to face some hardship. So be ready for it. It's a difficult industry to be in. Yes, and there were questions here.
Sir, why did you choose to popularize this butter chicken? And why not other dishes?
That's a good question. That's a great question. I will be very honest. I'll give you a very candid answer here. When Goila Butter Chicken came to me, I was somebody who was doing India on my platter, Roti Rasta India, and I was promoting dishes all across India. But Goila Butter Chicken is that golden hen that lays eggs. It makes me a lot of money. And that is the only answer I have for it, that butter chicken is such a national favorite dish that when you open a venture around it and you put a stamp on it and you serve a good recipe to people, thousands of people want it. Aur Bombay mein acha butter chicken aur kahan milta hai? Milta hai, ek do jagah milta hai, par wo ek do hi hai. So that's my reason for doing Goila Butter Chicken. It's more of a business call over a passion call, and you will have to take that in your journey as well. As a talent, you can go wherever you like, but when you turn 30, I am 32 now, and you have a family to take care of, your parents, you have to take responsibility for them, so money becomes a big part of that journey as well. And you do small, I won't call it compromise, but you do small, you deviate a little from your plan to make sure your financial goals are secured, and Goila Butter Chicken is mine. I'm not selling franchise here.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
When we ask foreigners about Indian food, they say India is all about curries.
Oh.
Then what would you suggest them then to prove that India is not about curries?
You know, I've actually been, my hashtag, as we all narrated in the beginning, was called Sadak Chef. And under Sadak Chef, our whole campaign is to change positioning about Indian stereotypes and twist it. Like one of the recent posts that I worked on, which really went viral, was that there is nothing that is called chai tea. It's either chai or it's either tea. Chai tea ka matlab kya hota hai? Chai tea ka matlab hai chai chai. So there's a lot of misconceptions about Indian food, like Indian food is only curry. So the only way to break that is to, now we have social media platforms to engage with them, to tell them, to do more shows, to travel, to do pop-ups in different countries and break those stereotypes about Indian food and India as a travel destination, in fact. I still remember I was in Sweden 3 years back where a very popular journalist in Sweden asked me that you're talking about food and travel in India. How do you travel and pee in India? Where do you pee while you're traveling? And it was a tricky question because I'm standing on this national platform. He's asking me, where do you pee when you're traveling in India? And my answer to them was, now we have 300 McDonald's on highways. So, we are a growing country when it comes to positioning of food and travel, and we are working really hard on it. I think the government is starting to align their thoughts with tourism in India, Incredible India, the whole campaign. So I'm hoping that will change, that Indian food is not just curry, and Indian food, in fact, is just not butter chicken either. In fact, at Goila Butter Chicken, we serve a lot of regional dishes, like baked mango rasgulla. Oh my God, I'm sorry, guys. And so on and so forth. I hope that answers your question.
Thank you, sir. You can take a seat if you please.
Oh, no, I'm good. I'm very energetic.
Any more questions from the audience? Hello.
Yeah.
So, hi, Saransh.
I can't see you, sorry.
Hi.
Haan, perfect.
I'm Karishma. Been a fan of your show on Food. So, I had a question that, I heard you that you had a dream to, you know, bring light to the Indian cuisine all over the world. So, how was your experience going through all the, like, you know, glamorizing yourself, glamorizing your passion, basically?
That's a great question. I think we live in a world where Facebook and Instagram teaches you to have your own personality, to have your own voice. That journey has been slightly tricky. You know what happens when you are following, when you are spending 2-3 hours a day on social media platforms, the world is your arena. You see so many things that are happening across the globe and you want to try and do everything. And I think that's the bad side of social media where 2 years back, I wanted to do everything that every other chef was doing. So my learnings from glamorizing my journey have been that it's only original if the idea comes from me. Okay. If it's not inspired by, it can be inspired by someone,
But if it's not copied by somebody's journey or idea, I think in this age of social media, we tend to copy ideas without even realizing. Subconsciously, we might see a story of a person or we might see a post of another person. We were like, mujhe bhi ye karna hai. Like, even if you're not saying it, we might be doing it. So my learning has been to remember the 12-year-old Saransh who made aloo parathas in the kitchen and he added his own masalas into it and he created his own recipe of aloo parathas and the same ethos we follow at Goila Butter Chicken. So the idea is to showcase socially what we do but not take a lot of inspiration from digital platforms. That's my take on it.
Thank you, Saransh. My first dish that I cooked was aloo paratha.
Map of India or round?
Pardon?
Was it shaped like map of India or goal parathe?
Goal it almost.
Wow, fantastic. Mine were map of India because.
So, very debatable question and I just want you to answer in yes or no. Coming from a vegetarian family.
Oh. No, I didn't mean it. Like, I'm sad for you. I'm happy for you.
Does veg biryani exist?
No. Achha, oh, we have a few questions more. Sorry. I thought I'll do mic drop and go away. Shit. Oh, it's like a fitting thing. Damn, this is like intense. Oh.
Not intense.
Kaun banega karodpati mein aapka swagat hai.
So, sir, all of us here eagerly wait for weekends these days because out of our hectic lives, we want something soothing for our weekends. At the same time, in the background, a chef's life is totally different on weekends. So, how is your life on a weekend?
To be very honest, so weekends for the food industry are very busy.
Because that's the day you do the most sale. So our industry, we don't have weekends, we have Mondays. Hum log Monday ko bar jaate hain, party karte hain, 50% discount bhi milta hai. Hoteliers, hospitality discount. So it's a no-brainer. You have to work on festivals, you have to work on weekends. That's what I said about the tough life, which is you have to sort of learn that you're in the hospitality service sector, where we say Atithi Devo Bhava. Guest is God, and that is the formula that we all work on, apart from Diwali, because I want chutti, I give everybody chutti.
So while growing up, whenever we spoke of the culinary world, there was only one name which was well known amongst the many, and that was Sanjeev Kapoor.
Perfect.
But now we have you, we have Vikas Khanna, we have Ranveer Brar, we have Nikhil Merchant and so many others. So do you think the industry is actually growing and y'all are eventually influencing the crowd now?
Absolutely. I don't think so. 20 years back, Next would have had a chef here doing a talk. So I think the journey of people who cook and people who serve, let's not forget people who serve in this discussion. There is no AH. All of that does not work in hotels and restaurants anymore. They're all professionals. People who are serving you are also learned. They have a certain skill of serving you. People who cook, there's a certain skill to that. So I think there's an immense amount of respect that has started to come to the industry. People are more aware of ki hotel mein khana banta hai. There are trained professionals, trained F&B, trained even barmen, these days, mixologists. There are so many different arenas in the world of food. You're not just a chef. You can be 100 different things. And I think it's all up for taking.
So you are known for butter chicken. So what is your next go-to dish after butter chicken?
Oh. The tough part here is that the journey of butter chicken is long. I think this brand is going to live on for many years. And our next step is from Mumbai. We are hoping that we can take it to places like Singapore, Dubai, London. And that's what the ambition is. We always aim for the sky. Just to let you know, I still knock on a lot of doors, and a lot of doors remain shut. So it's the journey is never ending, right? You can achieve something, and then you want something bigger, and then you want something bigger. So the cycle of fighting for what you love is always there. It never ends. So that is where Goila Butter Chicken is. And if I have to pick on another dish, I think this dish has become really popular, if I'm not wrong. Bhujing? Something of that sort. Bhujing chicken or something. Yeah, I'm going to look. See, nobody knows about it. That is it.
Definitely need to try that out now.
Perfect. Are we done? Are we done with the questions?
Yeah.
Fantastic. Okay, then now I can go.
Thank you so
much. Oh, mic drop.
No, but before you go, we want to felicitate you.
Of course.
For that, we would want our DRR, Rotarian Rotaractor, Nikita Ghamande, to please come on stage.
यहाँ लोग अनेक पर जज्बा है एक रगों में दौड़े खून जिसमें एक ही जुनून है यहाँ लोग अनेक पर जज्बा है एक रगों में दौड़े खून जिसमें एक ही जुनून दिलों के हम है नेक जरा आजमा के देख एकता है उमंग और उसी का गुरूर है छूना है आसमा चाहे रोके
टाइम फॉर लंच आगे लंच
या यू फाउंड अ माइक ड्रॉप मोमेंट फाइनली डिडंट यू
तू दुगना साहस दुगना जुनून जब तक है साहस